Do cell phone towers cause cancer? Experts say no. One woman isn't so sure. She's put her money where her mouth is, building a $30,000 wall to protect herself and her son from a cell tower.
But Marta Fisch has just learnt that a second telco is putting a tower close to her home. She is very unhappy about it, understandably. But is she right to be concerned? Tim Wilson went to see her and looked into the science.
This is Marta's wall. It's high, wide, doubles as a basketball court, but you wouldn't call it pretty.
It is an ugly wall, and it's an expensive wall. $30,000 worth of wall, which I didn't need. I needed like a hole in the head, right? But I am now having to protect my house from radiation.
Radiation, she says, is pouring out of this spark cell tower on an adjacent property.
I'm afraid of cancer, and I didn't feel that there was enough information about the dangers of cell tower emissions.
Marta believes her wall works. She says she has proof.
It's called an electrosmog meter, and it measures electromagnetic frequencies, which is the frequency that comes from cell towers.
So it's fluctuating, but generally around 0.1. Take the device outside the wall, however.
So there's more happening, isn't there?
There's double.
But Marta's wall has an unexpected problem. A new 2 degrees cell phone tower has been approved near her home. That's two now. Marta says she wasn't notified.
I'm pissed off that the institution that I pay rates to, that I assumed was going to be protecting my health and my neighbor's health, didn't even look into this application.
Auckland Council says
Council was contacted by Marta regarding this application prior to the decision being made. The planner considered all of Marta's viewpoints received in preparing their report.
Because we're doing more of this, we need cell towers. But are they safe?
The best scientific evidence we have suggests that they are safe.
A position backed up by the Ministry of Health, which told us
cell sites are designed to send the signals away from the site, not to the direct area.
But the new tower will be 5 and 6G, meaning more data and, Marta believes, more risk.
But there is some research done, well, completed in last year, that is yet to be peer-reviewed, but the American Cancer Society says is a paradigm shift, that 5G and 6G are a paradigm shift. We don't have enough information yet.
She's referring to a study done in the US, and yes, the American Cancer Society did call it a paradigm shift in the way we understand radiation and cancer risk.
So it's all about the balance of evidence. And so far the balance of evidence suggests that there's very slim, actually pretty flaky evidence to suggest that both with cell phones themselves and with cell towers that there is actually a cancer risk associated with them.
And what about the electrosmog meter?
The reality is that those levels, if the towers are performing to industry standards, are going to be very low.
Meanwhile, Marta, a self-proclaimed hippie, isn't convinced.
Are you a troublemaker?
Yeah, I am. It's another way of saying, do I fight for justice? Yes.
Having built a wall to keep out what she says is danger, Marta is tired of jumping through hoops. She feels both outflanked and hemmed in.
It's an interesting one, isn't it? Because the science does say that, no, those cell phone towers don't do you any harm at all.
Well, they kind of say slim risk.
Slim risk. But would you want to live beside one?
No, and no. I certainly wouldn't want to live beside two. I can understand why she is off.
Mm. But the other thing is the sun, that thing that sits above us in the sky, is shocking. I mean, that's got more radiation coming out of that than anything else.
It's hard to build a wall for the sun.
It's very hard.
I would be tempted to build a wall like Marta has. The other question I have is, well, do they need all these individual ones? Can the telcos not work together and create one big cell phone tower that suits everybody? That may be a really stupid question. I'm sure you'll let me know. But why not?